My dear brothers and sisters, we continue in our theme of the project of prophecy. That prophecy is a journey, is a project of many phases. And in an effort to ensure that purity of that project and the unity among people of different religious background, Quran introduces the concept of Kalimat Sawaa, the common word. Quran says,
say, O people of the book,
say, O people of the book, تعالوا إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم. Rise up to a common word between us and you. ألا نعبد إلا الله, that we worship none but God. ولا نشرك به شيئا, and we associate no partners with him. ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله. And some of us take not others as lords other than God. فإن تولوا فقولوا اشهدوا بأننا مسلمون. If they turn away, then say, bear witness that we are in obedience of his will. That is the will of God. My dear brothers and sisters, common word, Kalimat Sawaa, is an initiative, a vision, and a strategy. Let me repeat, an initiative, a vision, and a strategy. It is an initiative of the Muslim community reaching out to other faith communities to rise up together and make God their highest and loftiest goal in life. Believe in God, the Lord of all worlds, must transcend special interests, personal agendas, and political gains. The early Muslim community had learned before that initiative that all worldly things are not enough to unite them. Let alone to unite with other communities. God, as the common purpose for the believers, is the best hope for unity. If you want to unite between two individuals or more, between two communities or more, you have to search for something that is higher than all of them. And there is nothing higher than God to be the common goal to which all must strive and aspire. وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ لَوْ أَنْفَقْتَ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مَا أَلَّفْتَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَلَّفَ بَيْنَهُمْ. And he has put affection between their hearts, the hearts of the believers. Nor if you had spent all that is in the earth, could you have produced that affection. But God has done it. Meaning that the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Allah, or God subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the common goal. My dear brothers and sisters, uniting people is not a passive process. It requires a deep belief in the equality of people in the worship of their Creator. This meaning of equality is embedded in the word Sawaa. Kalimat Sawaa means they are at equal footing. They are equal. To worship God is to connect and get closer to Him. How do we get closer to Him? By realizing His beautiful names and attributes in our daily life. Love, hub, wood, mercy, rahmah, kindness, lutuf, wisdom, hikmah, knowledge, ilm, generosity, karam are among many other high values that all emanate from His beautiful names. They are innate, they are self-evident, and they are common to all mankind. Quran refers to these values as ma'ruf, which literally means universally known and acceptable. And Quran does not put any qualifier beside that word. Never you see in Quran talking about values that are Islamic or Muhammad or Abrahamic. Never. Quran always talk about values and refer to them as ma'ruf, that they are innate, they are self-evident and common to all mankind. My dear brothers and sisters, common word, as you have seen, is an initiative, but also a vision. A vision that is based on a new paradigm and a new pattern of thinking. This vision says that the differences between people of various religious backgrounds must not be a reason, that the differences between people of various religious backgrounds must not be a reason to divide them into inferior and superior, but they are sawaa, and such differences must not be obstacles to see the goodness of the other. In the same chapter that invites to common word, Kalimat Sawaa, we see a vivid and moving portrait of the people of the community. Listen, my dear brothers and sisters, to this beautiful description of the people of the book. It's a community that stands for the truth. من أهل الكتاب أمة قائمة يتلون آيات الله آناء الليل. They recite the verses of God all night long. وهم يسجدون, and they prostrate in adoration. يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر. They believe in God and the last day. ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر. They enjoy what is right and forbid what is wrong. ويسارعون في الخيرات, and hasten in good deeds. وأولئك من الصالحين. They are in the ranks of the righteous. وما يفعلون من خير فلن يكفرون. Of the good they do, nothing will be rejected of them. Nothing will be covered up. For God knows well those who do right. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالْمُتَّقِينَ. Don't you like to aspire and to have these qualities? I can speak for myself, I would say yes. This accumulation of character and best social practices provides a strong incentive to translate the vision into reality without compulsion, without coercion, or the archaic illusion of conversion. as the number of the followers of Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad, peace be upon all of them, increases over time. The challenge before them to unite under the overarching umbrella of common word increases. We can even enlarge the challenge and ask, what is the system or the mechanism or the model that is capable of bringing over 7 billion people today to live together peacefully on this planet? My dear brothers and sisters, the world is and was never monolithic, never homogeneous, but consists of various religions, multiple languages, ethnicities, races, and cultures. Mutual recognition and willingness to learn with, willingness to learn from, and the willingness to learn about the other are not optional, but the order of the day. Quran refers to this strategy as ta'aruf, which literally means the power and the courage to exchange knowledge and experiences with other nations and tribes and communities at an equal footage. Sawaa. This is ta'arafa. It's like a verb that comes out from two sides at equal footing. And celebrate their differences in an environment of mutual respect and appreciation. Ya ayyuha an-nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. O mankind, we created you from a single pair of a male and a female, and made you into nations and tribes, that you may know each other. Ta'aruf for humanity is its raison d'etre, the purpose of the creation, and the path towards peace and success. My dear brothers and sisters, we need all the worlds to perfect our worship and nearness to God. We cannot claim that we worship and praise Allah, the Lord of all worlds. It's what we say every day so many times, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. We cannot claim that we worship and praise God, the Lord of all worlds, and then divide among these worlds or ignore their important presence and contributions. Many educational, economic, social, and political challenges are awaiting our collective action. Power, political power in particular, is generated when people with different experiences choose to take action together. Hannah Arendt said, the only indispensable material factor in the generation of power is the living together of people. Henry Ford put it very beautifully. He said, coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is a progress. Working together is success. The message, my dear brothers and sisters, is go out and take the initiative. Embody the vision of common good and make your strategy about connecting with people around you. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله.